Another abstract thinking tool is association. So the classic example is brainstorming. So, but you don't need other people. Of course, it's much better if there are other people and they have different input and they stimulate each other. But you can do it alone. So actually, this is one of my method. I start to talk, I don't really prepare. Maybe I have some idea about the topic. I start to talk, and a lot of times I'm talking and no, that's a good idea. And when I'm talking, I'm associating to other things and new examples, new areas come up in my mind. And maybe this is the first time I think about that thing. Because when you are under a kind of pressure, I don't really feel pressure, but when you have to perform, so especially when there is a time limit. So I'm talking, and then I'm thinking about what is the next idea. And it's usually by association. So you can develop this method more, that you can be more conscious about how to use this tool. So it's not just random luck, but you really force yourself to perform. So you have a topic, you want to collect more ideas, you want to expand the topic and talk to your friends, talk to people, ask their ideas, and even if they say something that you don't like, but maybe that what they said can trigger a chain of thoughts, and then you can come up. Yes, and it's very important that you think about this chain of thoughts. So it's not just random ideas, it can be, but it's really, actually, when I'm developing this series about the abstract thinking, I have this, that I start to go in one direction, and then, oh, what is the next step in that direction, what is the next? And then I start a new chain, randomly maybe, or somehow I choose, maybe, sometimes association can be that you have a topic, let's say abstract thinking tools, and then you just come up with a total random topic or word, and you start to think, how can I connect to them? And oh, actually that is a good idea. And then you can continue the same logic and then go deep in more details in that field. So use association as a conscious tool to stimulate ideas, and then you can get more insight about that topic.